Thank you, Marco. It's a pleasure to be here today with you. My name is Carlos Monreal. I'm the CEO and founder of Plastic Energy. It's a company that was founded back in 2011 with the mission to develop a solution for plastics that are polluting today and could not be mechanically recycled. Plastics is a great material that has been growing the production over the last 50 years significantly, mainly because it's lightweight, it has a low footprint, can be used for different types of applications. So that is what has made it the plastics growth, and also right now why we are producing more than 1 million tons of plastics every single day. That is the positive side of the story. The negative side is that we are only recycling the 14% of those plastics being produced, with more than 8 million tons of plastics going to our oceans every single year. This is something that we have to stop. This is something that the social media and the different campaigns over the last few years, they have helped us to get more educated into this type of situation. And also the banning of the importation of plastics by China in 2018, plus all the new policies and voluntary commitments of the different companies have helped to really make everybody more aware of what has to happen with plastics. Today, the plastics that we are recycling, they are following the yellow line. What that means is that the plastics, once that we are being, that have been used, they are collected, and then they are mechanically recycled into different type of products. However, the majority of those plastics, once that they have been used today, they follow the red arrow that you can see on the slide, which mainly means that those plastics end up into incineration, landfilling, or worse, leakage into the environment. So what we are proposing with chemical recycling, which is the technology that we have developed, is to be able to, those type of plastics, process it and produce an output that is a liquid that can be used as a replacement of fossil oil feedstocks to produce new plastics with the same type of specs than virgin quality plastics. So therefore, chemical recycling can increase recyclability of the plastics, can prevent pollution, can produce an output that has virgin quality and can be used for recycled content to follow the regulations and also the voluntary commitments of the different brand owners. And in the other hand, also reduce the dependence on fossil oil in order to produce new plastics. Chemical recycling, as I was mentioning before, is a complementary solution to mechanical recycling, where mainly the difference is that with chemical recycling, we do not have to separate by type of plastics, unlike in mechanical recycling. And the output can be used for food grade packaging, something very difficult to do with mechanical recycling. And the quality of the output is exactly the same than virgin quality. Plastic Energy has developed the technology over the last 10 years. It's patented globally. We have two industrial plants operating in Spain since 2015. And that has made us become an industry leader in chemical recycling and have developed different type of partnerships that you will see later on with different type of companies in order to address and increase the recycling quotas of plastics globally. But something very important to remark is that we are focused in the plastics to plastic process. We do not produce energy. We do not go plastics to energy. We do not go into the plastics to fuel. We do plastics to plastic process. So mainly, as Marco mentioned, we have been raising capital in order to develop the technology and also to build the plants that we are operating. We have been raising in total close to $300 million over the last 10 years, and particularly 145 million euros in the last few months through three institutional investors that we have incorporated into the company. So in order to be able to support the rollout of new projects that we have in our pipeline of projects. However, because there is such a big demand and such a need to increase recycling, we are not going to be able to do this only by raising capital all the time. So we have within our business model also an evolution into the licensing of the technology for other companies to be able to use their own balance sheet and be able to license in our technology, increase recycling of plastics. In order to do this, we have done a collaboration with a company that is very well established, it's called Accents, and they are fully dedicated to license technologies to the petrochemical sectors. The company has different type of certifications. I'm not going to go through this. For us, it was important to have traceability of the process, what type of feedstock plastics we are processing and what we converted into. We have different awards. We were mentioned by the pioneers of Bloomberg, also recognized within the top power players within the chemical industry, in the industry. We had three different global awards on the chemical sector. Anyway, we are proud to be working in the within the circular economy, reducing pollution, to increase recycling, and reduce the oil dependence on the from fossil oil sources. The type of plastics that we can process, as I was mentioning before, is any type of plastics. We do not have to separate it by type of plastics. The only ones that we do not like is PET bottles or PVC. We don't have to wash the plastics when we have to process it, which is a big advantage. And as I say, for every, the output has similar quality than virgin type of feedstocks used for the production of new plastics, with yields where for every 1 ton of plastics coming in through our process, we produce 850 liters of our tack oil, which is the product that we produce. This is not science fiction, this is a reality. We had been, it was presented in Davos back in 2019 with a company, Savic, that it was purchasing our output and produced a circular polymer that it was later on being used by different converters to produce final products used by companies like Unilever, Vivensions, Tupperware, with the same type of qualities like virgin quality plastics. Examples that I was mentioning are, for example, the Magnum ice cream top, the Philadelphia cheese packaging, and others that you can see in this slide. The market is large, the demand is huge, and we are recycling in Europe something like about 5 million tons of plastics today, but the goal by the European Commission is to double the quantities of plastics that we recycle in Europe from 5 million to 10 million tons by 2025. This is going to request investments in the range of close to 10 billion euros to be deployed over the next coming years in facilities that are going to be able to process those type of plastics. We have different projects that you can see in the slide under different phases of construction in Europe, Asia, where there will be a bigger investment requested than in Europe, most likely closer to 15 to 20 billion over the next 10 years in order to achieve exactly the same rates of recycling that we have in Europe. Or similar situation in the USA, where the current recycling rates in the USA are very low because most of the plastics are not being sorted, you know, at the households, and they are all being sent to a landfill, which is the cheapest way to manage the waste in the USA. Besides the technology, besides the solution for recycling, besides the opportunity for as a financial investment that can provide excellent returns and also do something good, is something important. What is going to be the environmental impact of those type of technologies? We have conducted at the LCA life cycle analysis done by a third-party company called Quantis, and mainly the main messages you can read them, and you can download our report from our website, which is mainly we can produce in our process. It has a lower climate change impact than incineration with energy recovery, or even producing those plastics using fossil oil feedstocks. So this is extremely encouraging and makes us, our company, be looking to the future with a very promising and a very optimistic way to be able to increase recycling. Thank you very much, Marco.